You're listening to The Dean Blundell Show on 102.1 The Edge. Some of the material in The Dean Blundell Show is not suited for all audiences. Listener discretion is strongly advised.
It's like everything everywhere is going crazy, so we don't go out anymore. We sit in the house, and slowly the world we're living in is getting smaller, and all we say is, please, just leave us alone.
Well, I'm not going to leave you alone. I want you to get mad.
I want all of you to get up out of your chairs and go to the window. Open it and stick your head out and yell.
The Dean Blundell Show.
This is mass madness, you maniacs.
102.1 The Edge.
This is your Edge.
Hold it.
Files with Dean Blundell on the air.
A South Carolina woman arrested last week for going door-to-door attempting to sell items that passed their expiration date, including a box filled with adult VHS movies.
Really?
Yeah. Jeanette Ellis said she came across some tapes in the trash, thought she'd make a couple bucks by selling them to her neighbors. Apparently, no one uses VCRs anymore. She didn't know that because she still has one. All I got, sir, AVHSs, eh?
Oh, no.
She says, yep. One of her potential customers so offended by how Stella got her tube packed on VHS, she called police to report her solicitation. She was arrested for trying to sell porn without a license.
You need a license to sell a porn, do you?
Oh, so, yeah. I didn't know that. Apparently.
Really? She didn't know that people weren't using... like VHS, DVDs and Blu-rays now?
No. People don't even use DVDs that much anymore.
I know.
Makes me laugh, though.
Have you ever seen Blu-ray porn, though?
No. Is it awesome?
Yeah, no.
It's not?
Again, it's
too much.
It's too close.
I can see too much. I can see too many blemishes. I hope that's a zit, not an ingrown hair.
Yeah, I'd almost prefer the VHS porn. Yeah.
I liked it when the detail wasn't so great.
Yeah.
Porn would be one of those things you just wouldn't want to see in super HD.
Exactly. You know what I mean? It's cool, a little grainy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you miss all the diseases and infections and stuff like that. They just look like more hair. New York man won't be laughing much anytime soon. Apparently he got ticketed for doing it in his own home. Robert Schiavelli says, yeah, I like to laugh, but he blamed the volume on his need to send a message to his neighbor who said he mocks him with taunts like retard because he has a neurological impairment. The neighbor, Dan O'Hanlon, it's a cool neighborhood, Danny O'Hanlon, called the cops to say he could hear Schiavelli across his driveway laughing all the time and it's driving him nuts. Schiavelli said since he had an injury back in the day, he can't stop laughing. He just laughs really loud, and he laughs at really funny things. But he's a happy guy, generally, right? He's one of those really light bellows. Oh, they can't stop laughing.
Very cordial guy. Yeah.
The police showed up, had a list, and they agreed with him, wrote him a summons and a ticket, which this guy's lawyer calls laughable, says he intends to contest it as it would be impossible for his client to not laugh. Just get him to listen to Virgin in the morning. That might help.
Just play that on a loop.
Yeah. Put Mad Bitches podcasts on during the day.
There will be no laughter.
No. That'll cure you. No one will laugh. What I did laugh about this morning was Rob Ford back in the spotlight. You know, he was doing so well for about a month and a half where we didn't hear from him. Sarah Thomson, who ran for mayor... and she's the editor of a woman's magazine, I believe, or maybe she's the publisher. I can't remember. Anyway, Sarah Thomson ran for mayor at one point in time, lost. She was at some Canadian Junior Action Party event with Rob Ford last night. Now, Fordsy, our mayor, our 300-and-some-odd-pound mayor, the tub of guts, there's a picture of him. He's wearing a white shirt, and he is sweating, and he has the booze eyes going. You know the yellow ones?
It is.
Like, I am ass-faced, hammered.
It is really extremely embarrassing. It's not even funny. It's embarrassing.
No. And, you know, say what you want about Sarah Thomson posting this picture. I think it's in good taste, though, because allegedly he had his hand on a place of her that he shouldn't. I don't know if it was her ass or back or bra. I don't know. And he looked at her and said, you should have been in Florida with me last week because my wife wasn't there. Woo. To which Thomson replies, seriously, I wanted to punch him in the face. And she says, happy International Women's Day. Which, by the way, ladies, good for you. Congratulations.
Yeah, that's
you get
nice.
Your own day.
What is it? Does they celebrate being
I don't know.
Better sex?
Yep.
Yeah.
I don't know how or why, but
yeah.
We should have Happy Man Day just to fight back. Anyway, so great part is the stain in the middle of his shirt.
Oh.
And his head is soaking wet, and his eyes are half closed. And I cannot say without question that he's hammered, but it looks to me he's absolutely wasted.
He doesn't look healthy, yes. And at an event, you would like to think that there's probably a few drinks there.
And she's not half bad looking. Like if you look like Rob Ford, I could understand why Rob Ford would want to put his hand on her ass. If that's indeed what he did.
Yeah, after a few drinks.
I can understand why he'd look at her and go, hey, you should have been in Florida with me last week. You made me rate the greatest.
Yeah, I think that's funny. That part of it too. I like. Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty ballsy if you ask me. Yeah.
The picture, though.
Yeah. Oh. But if he seems to think he's going to get anybody to go to Florida with him looking like that, he's in trouble.
Can you imagine him on a beach?
It looks like he got Sanchez underneath his shirt. Can I imagine him on a beach? Dude. Tourists would just come flying in from everywhere trying to push him back in the water. Let's save it! Don't touch his blowhole! Can you imagine him just sidling up to Sarah Thompson?
I should have been in Florida with me last week. My wife wasn't there.
I just always think, imagine if this was a mayor of another city, we're now the fourth largest city in North America.
Yeah. Prestigious, isn't it? Man, do we got the right guy for the job. I love this guy. He is so hammered. You get hammered at a Canadian Junior action party event.
Wow.
Sweating. Like it.
He just looks terrible.
Oh my god.
He looks like he needs to go to a hospital.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah.
He looks like he's in major trouble. You know what? It looks like someone just before they're about to die.
Yeah.
You know, like his eyes are closed. He has eyes yellow, his eye all around his face. He just looks terrible. I'm going to die. That's what that look is. And it might be now. But before I do,
I'm just going to grab this ass over here and say you should have been in Florida with me last week.
That's,
you know. Well, you come out to the mayor's office and we're sharing O'Henry or something.
You want to sit in the big chair? I know you tried to get there.
I'll let you sit there for a fee. No money, though. No money. I'll figure it out.
I mean, I'll sit on it first, and you can sit on me.
Well, if you can, that is. I don't even know. I mean, it's quite the lumbar support I got here.
Those are your Edge Files, whatever the hell day it is in March year 2013.
The Edge Files on 102.1 The Edge.
The Dean Blundell Show.
It's gonna scar me for life, and it's gonna haunt me forever. Even at an old age.
102.1.
I don't know how you put up with it.
The Edge.
Happy International Women's Day, ladies. This is a day for us to celebrate women and their rights and all the wonderful things you do and that you get shafted back in the day where you weren't allowed to vote or something. I don't know. I don't know why we do these, but, you know, good for you. It wasn't like you were oppressed or anything. You know what I mean?
I guess in some countries still, unfortunately, women are deemed as the lesser sex.
Well, that's why they say the international, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Like here in Canada and the United States, I mean, Jesus.
Yeah.
We got a couple female premiers. I think we got three of them. We got one here in, I think, well, Kathleen Wynne. We have 2.5 female premiers.
Happy International Women's Day.
No, just joking. We have 3 female premiers in this country. We've got women in very high positions of authority, and it's as it should be. Women are just as capable as men of doing pretty much anything.
More so.
Well, absolutely. There's a lot of things men can't do that women can do.
Like give birth.
Yep. Way better at that than us. Killer at menstruating, too. Very good at it. But no, my point is that there's no reason for anybody to be looked at in any different light, whether you're male or female, what you can or can't do. I mean, it's not, if you put them against each other in like an MMA fight, maybe. Or if you put them against each other in like, throwing a javelin or the 100-meter dash, the best man, best woman in the world. Sure. I mean, there's a disparity only because the genetics are different. It doesn't mean anybody's less capable of doing a great job as a president, a prime minister, a doctor, a lawyer. You know what I mean?
Yeah, generally, we're just naturally, by nature, we're more fit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's just like, in Norway, they got every bunch of people with blonde hair. Same thing. That's it's just part of the deal.
Exactly. And I mean, I'm talking the top of the cream of the crop for both sexes.
You said cream.
No, because I'm sure we're not, you put us against some women in some sports.
Yeah.
We'd get our asses.
Oh, I don't think so.
You think you could compete with a world champion 200 meter hurdlist right now?
Big time. I'd win.
I want to see that.
I'd win. Name another one.
The marathon.
I'd win.
What about the...
winning.
Cooking.
I just won that.
Cooking?
I won. Okay. I beat everyone. I always used to say, if I could play professional golf against a woman, lights out.
And then you could win...
Name me the world's best female golfer right
now. Is it Michelle Wee? I don't even know anymore.
I don't know.
Okay, there's a new up and coming like a 12-year-old sensation.
Yeah, okay. I would kick her ass. I'm sorry, it's a fact.
All right,
give me something else.
Would you go in the ring with one?
Finished,
MMA?
Done. One.
You hear about this transgender one though?
Yeah, I did. Post-op or pre-op?
She's got it removed, I believe. And I only say that because I watched her fight and it looked like nothing was there.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah, there's a transgendered woman. This is my whole point. Yeah. Those are all jokes, friends. I understand. I'd probably lose at something, but not much. Anyway. It's truth. So the it's 100% truth. This transgendered woman that was a man and turning into a woman. What's the story? Give me the story.
So this is she was a man.
Happy International Women's Day.
Is a woman. Her name is Fallon Fox, and she's like this big MMA fighter. I believe she's on a future card coming up that's like going to be one of these popular, I think, UFC ones. And some deem it not being fair because she was born a male. And just because of what we were saying, how, males generally are physically and naturally stronger. But then there was that case of the Balzinha one. What was her name?
Oh, Castor Balzinha.
Yeah.
No, Semenya.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's got the balls on the inside and a hermaphrodite, right?
Yeah, but then they allowed
that. Inside nuts. No, but what's the story? This Fallon Fox, how long ago did she have the surgery?
Do you want to hear a little bit of it?
I do want to hear some of it. Yeah. Let's have a listen. This is interesting.
I find myself talking to myself as I walk around the house, explaining my positions to myself, because I have to be able to express myself to people because it's such a complicated issue. Playing devil's advocate with myself to try and have to express myself to everyone. It's very, very hard. It's like a 24-hour thing, because I know there's a possibility that people are gonna come after me. They're not gonna understand, so I have to be ready, it's like MMA, be ready.
When I came out, the biggest misconception
another friend.
Was probably that I was cheating.
That's a woman.
Which is crazy because I came out as a transgender male, meaning that I had no surgeries and I took no hormones. My birth sex is female. I was playing on a female team. How am I cheating?
Some people believe I have an automatic advantage.
I'd beat that
over
guy up
other
too.
Female MMA fighters.
But it's a
so
woman.
They think that, whatever. Well, she has to be stronger because she used to be a male. But if they look into the science of it and what the hormones do to the body, to the male body, once taken over a period of time, I believe it's from like 1 year to 2 years.
2 to 3 years.
2 to 3 years, yeah. It dissipates.
Yeah, well, and that's unfair.
Yeah, it'd be weird, right?
It was the same thing that was brought up a couple of years ago with the Olympics, where that one the guy turned into a girl and wanted to race against girls, but it would have just been a nightmare. Do you know what I mean?
But I think they allowed it after that.
Oh, did they?
Yeah, I believe.
Did it win?
I don't know. They should have a third category for the iffies. Where they make him race against horses and stuff.
Oh, dear.
What?
Oh, wow. Happy International Women's
Day. Yeah, iffies. It's called transgendered people iffies. That's not a bad one.
That's awesome.
It's a little iffy. Not sure what it is. If it's a guy, if it's a girl, iffy. Yeah, I'd beat an iffy up for sure. Like if it was like an octagon fight, you know what I'm saying? If it was an MMA fight, yeah. I was fighting an iffy.
Kick him square into something.
I'm gonna kick you and your re-engineered bitch. See if you get up. Whatever it is that I just kicked.
The Dean Blundell Show. Wake up. Mornings. Wake up.
Folks, got some breaking news, some sad breaking news.
Sad?
Justin Bieber collapsed on stage from shortness of breath during a performance in London Thursday night.
And the sad part is?
He got back up.
That's a shame. Remember about a year ago when he puked on stage?
Yeah.
That was funny, too.
Well, he was full. That's what all the boys said. Oh, we know why he puked. He was full. So I tweeted yesterday that Justin Bieber faked his collapse. That's what I think. My theory is it's such bad press, and he's been such a dickhead that he faked his big collapse on stage. So then I started getting like hate from Bieber fans yesterday. I laughed so hard at some of these tweets, they seriously made me piss my pants. Justin Bieber fans are the most delusional retards ever. They really, really are. It's almost like he's got them under some kind of spell, some kind of tard spell.
They're like modern day Nazis.
Yeah, they are, totally. This is from Giraffe Bieber. This is at Giraffe Bieber, these modern day Nazis. Yeah, and their leader is this little Hitler.
Except put an S before it. Okay.
Anyway, this is from at Giraffe Bieber. This made me laugh.
See?
Yeah. And they CC'd Electronic Robbie. At Dean Blundell. Slut, I hope you die instead of Justin. Oh. Feel me?
See?
Feel me.
Feel it. Sorry. Feel it.
Hope you die?
Yeah.
That's Nazi talk.
That is. It's what the Nazis
it's
did.
True.
They killed people.
It's terrible.
All the believers are Nazis. That's what they are. They're like Hitler youth.
That's such a jump.
Such a no, leap. It's true. It's not a leap. It's okay. Not a stretch. Okay. There's a big connection there.
Yeah, okay. Fair enough.
If they acted on their words, they would be. I'm serious.
True. That's, well,
yeah.
So, because I tweeted, Bieber rushed to the hospital after collapsing during London concert. And so I tweeted, he faked it for sure. Just hashtag, he faked it
that's
for sure.
That's all you wrote, too. Yeah, that's all you that bad.
And then I started getting, like, people say, you should die.
Oh, my.
I believe you are out of line with the Bieber. You must suffer the death.
But I think he faked it. That's my theory. My theory.
I think
it's
a good theory, actually.
That's
faked
legit.
It. Big time.
Especially after the 2 hour delay. Now they have an excuse to say, okay, listen, you know, he couldn't go on that day because
he
he's
had
actually,
health concerns.
Yeah, and they didn't want to talk about it. But now that it's come out and he fainted during this concert,
And you know what? And then he went backstage. Yeah, he puked during another concert because he had too much man junk in his guts. So anyway, so he, it's true, he had too much man junk in his guts. So he yesterday he takes a 20-minute break, goes backstage, huffs a little wiener, and then comes back out, and he's like this. I'm going to finish this for you guys. And all the all went, that sounds good, Bieber. Sing it out.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thinking one city at a time is what he's doing.
I'm going to finish out here.
Me and my little penis and balls invading your city. I will collapse. I know what I will do to win them back. I will collapse on stage. Then I will come back out after huffing three wieners backstage.
It gives me the energy to get back on stage.
It was either a vitamin B shot or three boys named Ricky. I chose Ricky's.
And they all ate a lot of celery.
Vitamin C.
The Dean Blundell Show on the Edge.
Time for your phone calls. 416-870-EDGE, 870-3343. Open phones it is. Still to come on the show today, we've just confirmed Sarah Thomson. Is she a city councilor or a former city
councilor? She's a former city councilor. I think she was running for...
For mayor at one point.
Yeah.
Mayor and liberal.
Oh, for MP.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. Yeah. Now she's got all dreads and everything.
Yeah, she's all dreaded up. I think she's like a mother and stuff too.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I think so. Hey, The Edge.
Crazy hair.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey, who's
it? I'm Danielle.
What's up?
It's my birthday.
Wow, are you high?
Yeah, I'm really stoned.
What are you stoned on? What are you high on at 7 in the morning?
Well, me and my dad just smoked a beat.
You and your dad, huh?
Oh, yeah.
How old are you?
I just turned 18.
Oh, it's a good morning for you and your dad to have some father-daughter time behind a bong.
And a joint, too, yeah.
Oh, God.
That is insane.
Nice. So you just turned 18 and you got stoned with your dad?
Yeah.
Boy, the future's so bright, you gotta wear shades, huh?
You're funny.
Huh?
I've never been on the edge. I'm actually excited.
Okay, cool. What's your dad doing today? Is he going to work?
Yeah, he's coming home early to come smoke, and he's getting like 12. He's picking up.
Oh, he's getting 12 beers?
No, 12 grams.
Oh, 12 grams of marijuana? Oh,
you're 18?
Is the children's aid helicopter just flown away?
No, I've already been through that.
Oh, you have.
Okay. I've been in a group home, foster home,
and then now your dad's got you back, and he's making sure that you grow up right by going to get 12 grams of weed.
Is he a good father? Do you other than is,
to be honest, not really. He's an asshole.
What a birthday it is today.
Yeah, but today is special.
Today's a special a-hole, huh?
Yeah.
Are you in school or anything?
No, I skipped like Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, but I went Monday.
Celebrating birthday week at 18, are you?
And I have March break.
Whoa, man, that's like a 2-week holiday. What's your name?
Do you guys get high? I was wondering.
What's your name?
Danielle.
And where are you from? Where do you live?
I live in Richmond Hill.
Okay, Danielle in Richmond Hill.
Yeah.
What does your dad do for a living? Yeah.
He has like temp jobs.
Oh, he's a temp.
He can't hold one down.
He goes and covers for people.
Kind of, yeah. He's working on trying to get a full one, I guess.
Sounds like he's good with his money too if he's spending his temp job dough on.
I know,
weed.
And I'm always complaining. I'm like, why are you always getting 12? Can I have money?
Yeah.
Because I want to buy weed.
I know, you should be complaining about that at the age of 18. Sweet.
What do you plan on doing for a future?
I want to be like a, I don't know, a work, one of those workers, like a social worker or something.
Always the social.
You know why? I'll tell you why. She wants to be a social worker.
Why?
She wants to be a social worker because she's got plenty of experience in this department. So she seems to think she could use her experience to help others, right?
Yeah.
Or something like that.
Wow.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Do you have a boyfriend?
Yes, I do.
And how old is he?
18.
And what does he do? Does he go to school?
Yes, he goes to college and up north. I don't know.
You don't know, eh?
He made it to college, though. Good for him.
Yeah.
Yeah, small engine mechanics.
What?
Mechanics? For small engine mechanics.
Small engine mechanics. So he wants to fix lawnmowers for the rest of his life.
And boats and stuff and snowmobiles.
Oh, okay.
That's cool.
Sorry.
Okay.
Yeah,
yeah. Right on, though.
My dad did that.
Yeah. It works on pretty cool snowmobiles.
All right.
You ever taken for joyrides?
No.
What's
no.
So you're just going to be high all day. Is that correct?
Yeah.
That's how you want to spend your whole day? Kind of phasing in and out of sleep and smoking doobs with your dad?
I've never been drunk, so I want to get drunk.
You've never been drunk?
No.
You've just been high?
Yes.
When did you start smoking marijuana?
A year ago.
With who? Your dad?
My boyfriend.
There's got to be rules against this kind of stuff. I
know.
There?
It's so odd.
There are rules against, like, a dad getting his 18-year-old daughter 12 grams of weed.
18 is an adult now. I think before it, maybe.
Yesterday.
Yeah.
Or, like, she's not going to school, right? So she's get, like, I know for a fact, because I'm going through a divorce, that you know, one of the hallmarks is your kid's not going to school. You're in deep crap. So your dad, like, where's your mom?
My mom is, like, around, yeah.
No, but where is she? You don't live with her? You never live with her?
No, yeah, she lives with her.
Is she away? Oh, your mom and dad live together?
Yeah.
Oh.
It's terrible, because, like, she's always bitching about, like, because, I don't know, yeah, it's confusing.
What's that? No, go ahead. She's always bitching about what?
Yeah, because, like, yesterday we had a fight and I had to go downstairs, and, like, I usually don't talk to her in front of her about it. So, like, I was like, here, I have your bowl upstairs, and, like, we had a fight and stuff, and he's like, I want a cigarette, and he's like, I want a bowl, and I was like, it's upstairs.
Like, of weed?
Yeah.
What a fight.
Man. Your mom smokes dope? Does your mom smoke drugs, too?
No.
You're afraid your dad's going to have a heart attack?
No, my mom, because, like, she's so stressed.
Yeah.
Oh, she's trying to take care of you and your father.
Does your mom work?
Yeah, she has a steady job.
Yeah, well, here, this is the picture I'm getting. Your mom works, doesn't do drugs, doesn't drink. Your dad does drugs, drinks. She's got a temp job. You're a bit of a stoner at the age of 18, not going to school. Do you think she's going
to
be...
Actually, I lied to you. I'm 17.
Do you think she's going to be stressed out?
Yeah.
Just turned...
You just turned 17?
I thought talk to me if I was, like, 17.
No, I wouldn't.
Oh.
Yeah. Child services. Now, you ever watch the show Shameless?
No.
You never watched the show Shameless?
No, I never heard of it.
You might hit home.
Yeah, go watch it.
Yeah.
It's like looking in a mirror.
Happy birthday. By the Edge.
Yo.
What's up?
Oh, my God, guys. This has been the funniest 2 weeks. Honestly, I was going to come on the show and do some sort of Zahara's public service announcement.
Oh, with the Justin Bieber's.
We have an island of misfit penises for you.
You know what? It's not that far off, Todd, just because some believers threatened to kill me yesterday because I said he was faking his collapse on Twitter. And then Todd likened him to the new Nazis. And you know what? Not far off, because they go, like, if you insult Justin Bieber and his legion of retards figure it out, you will get not just hate mail. You'll get severed heads sent to your house. It's
right
the most
to
amazing.
Death. It's right to death.
It's straight to death. And much like the Nazis taught.
Yeah. And you know, I say it. And listen, I'm a Jewish man who has a ton of empathy and one of the most tragic events in human history. But, you know, you say it, these kids, if you give them power, who knows what they would act on?
Guys. Hello?
Yeah, we're here.
Oh, yeah, you're still... Oh, I thought you... Oh, sweet. Okay, so, yeah, that part this morning, honest to God, I was laughing. My name is Walter, by the way. But I was laughing. I was having a rough morning. Oh, my gosh, you guys cracked me up this morning with this Bieber and this Hitler and this... It's amazing. But, guys, the other funniest part of last week was the Jennifer Lawrence biggest fan. When I first heard it, I thought it was like an echo. Like, I was like feeling really sorry for the story. I'm like, oh man, like I can't believe this cerebral palsy. Like, and then I hear the echo in the background, and I hear you, Dean and Todd, going like, yeah, no, like this is serious. Like, we should really like.
It was sweet.
It's very sweet,
it was,
dude.
That part's hearing. Your comments after, and then I realized it wasn't an echo. It was him, and I like I'm not in a similar situation, but when oh my God, I couldn't stop laughing. Can you play like 30 seconds of that?
Yeah.
I just want to hear, and I'm the biggest fan, and oh, dude, I shouldn't be doing that. Like, honest to God, I have the biggest heart, but, like, in that story, I started with having the biggest heart, and you guys...
Shrunk it?
You guys turned into making fun of a kid with you without actually telling
No,
we were making fun.
No.
We were not making fun.
Just because you're laughing.
No, I'm winking back at you. No, I get it. Yeah, not having fun. Yeah, I know. I know you weren't. Do some more Hitler and Bieber this morning, guys. Listen, I listen to you every morning. My whole work listens to you guys. I know they're listening to me right now. I won't say their name because, never mind. What's up, Pure Later? On my way. Guys, we love you. We listen to you all the time. You guys, do some more Hitler and play 30 seconds of that. Yeah, I'm the biggest fan, and I, Dave Renoir, and come on, guys.
I love this guy.
Yeah, that's
hey, what's
so
your name?
Prompt.
Oh, he's gone.
I
was
going
to give him big ups. Walter. You got it? Yeah. All right, here. This is Jennifer Lawrence's biggest fan. They grew up together. He went to school together. It's so cute.
Yeah, it's a very nice story of this fellow right here.
Okay, have a listen.
They're first friends, 12 years.
12 years.
And they went to Cameron Middle School together, but they actually attended the same church together. He told her, and he told me, he said, Mom, she's going to be famous.
Yeah,
and I'm her number one fan.
Yeah, my mom.
He looks through magazines. And anything he can find to see pictures of
Jennifer.
And it doesn't have to be on the front cover. He'll look through the magazines and try to find pictures of her and enjoying collecting them. And he now has a complete file of courier articles. It's been over a year or so. Jennifer knocked on the door on an October day and asked to see his articles because she hadn't seen any of them, and she enjoyed sitting up here on the bed and looking at him with Andy, and it was a lot of fun for him. She has sent him recently an article from Malibu, and it came in the mail, and it was actually a magazine that she was on, and she autographed it for him and sent it to him, says, Hi, Andy. I miss you. Love, Jennifer. And he really believes he's still her number one fan.
Yeah, my fan.
He said dressed up today because he had announced that he really believes Jennifer's going to win on Sunday night. And he wants to dress up and be part of the party, for the Oscar on Sunday night. And he will be in close contact, and he will probably make a contact Sunday night or Monday. And we're hoping that she's going to win.
That's beautiful. Derek's under the weather.
I am sick.
Yep. You all right?
I'm sorry.
It's okay. I know. You got tears? Crying so hard.
I think we all got a little caught.
Oh, boy.
The Dean Blundell Show. Mornings.
It's so crazy.
On the Edge.
Hey, real quick, congratulations to Global News, Catherine McDonald, climb reporter. Crime reporter just gave birth to a beautiful baby girl yesterday morning. We didn't want to say, I couldn't say anything because her husband, Adrian, said they were 2 days away from coming up with a name. So it was Baby X. Within 3 seconds of that email, Catherine emailed me and said, please welcome Eve Dylan Montgomery into the world.
Yeah. So Adrian's got no say.
She named it without him even knowing.
Sounds about right.
Yeah.
Good
so,
for her.
Congratulations to Kath and Adrian on the birth of their lovely, beautiful little girl, Eve. That's a nice thing. First-time parents. And, Adrian's happy because it's a tax write-off.
Already getting those government
he's claiming independence already. He's trying to tell the government she's three.
She's been in daycare for 3 years.
She's already working, actually.
No, truly congratulations to him. It's great. Well, week in review coming up in just a few minutes. T-Bone, a word to describe today's week in review, please.
The Dean Blundell Show, 102.1 The Edge.
And now, the Dean Blundell Show presents The Week in Review. Yes. It's true. Week in Review.
Hey, so Justin Bieber collapsed on stage yesterday.
Yeah, sure, buddy.
Yeah, that's what I said. Yeah, okay. All right. It's not... He faked it. Total faker. Oh, I'm not feeling it.
Yeah.
Drugs, man. Two things. Either he faked it or there's some drugs. Got some drug issues. Already. 19, not bad. Let's just hope he has a much shorter drug career than Whitney Houston. Maybe one of them collapses, it'll be real. Which leads us to your week in review. God put me on this planet for a couple of reasons. One, to be a dad. That's the first one.
Yep.
And the other reason he put me on this planet was to drive a wedge into the collective sphincter of Torontonians, specifically men. It's a fetus in a bag?
Yeah, well, I don't know.
What a terrible adoption agency.
That needle was all the way up there, right in the cavity, right in the old holy of holies, right up there.
You'd have to walk ever so gingerly.
No sudden turns.
Right in the old fudge factory there.
I don't care if you have 35 million Twitter followers. You have a tiny little pecker.
Going to eat her placenta? People are still saying his wiener grow into his body. Bisexual slutty college years.
It was the sorest I've ever been.
Belly hangs lower than your dicky do.
Circle jerk.
He puts the jerk in circle jerk.
I have a fetus in a bag. I'll take one.
Which one of you Cardinals is going to be Pope?
Yeah, people still call those, do they?
Yeah.
Phone sex lines?
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe not, actually.
About that the other night.
Manderson Pooper.
Gravy Dipper.
Biebs was busy huffing wiener backstage.
He looks like the boy version of those Victoria's Secret models. In that. I gave you the keys, so you
bring it right back. Maybe he was backstage lamenting the small penis he has.
Which is fine.
3 weeks later, I still couldn't drop.
Jesus!
Hassles.
Jesus Christ.
Looks like someone smeared from her.
My nuts have anxiety.
Shart the bed.
Come for a tan with me.
I'll take out my teeth and rub your back. Give us a twirl.
Can you believe how small this little thing
was? He's 19, right? Like he
dude, I had a man.
Yeah, that's what
I'm
saying. Yeah, like that's at that point, that's what you have for the rest of your life. Now I'm on a roll, half
a million for I had a man wiener when I was 19. Did I just say that?
Yeah, you did.
Swag, swag, swag on yo. Chilling by the fire.
Ain't found one big enough.
So do you have a handicapped vagina?
You guys can go shove it up your
He couldn't even feel me through that big poofy skirt. His little thing.
Morning, lady. You gave me gonorrhea in the mouth.
I know. I have a tainted taint because of you.
Let's go to Florida.
Talking to the ladies about their shoes.
Well, poopy skirt and that little thing.
Hang on, I just got a whiz on your legs. Sure. Guess which nut you came from.
Oh, man, he's got a small twig and berries.
I had man wiener when I was 19.
Made out with a couple guys and put a few fingers here and there. You know what I'm saying.
Yeah, let me show you. Come here.
A little bungalingus.
Punked for the last 13 years prior to my separation. What was on the other side of that hole?
The incentive side of me is flipper over.
Bubblegum crap.
Start it, and then you pinch it, you put the cup on the urinal, and then you finish.
Todd has testicular anxiety.
It starts with stubble. That's what we're saying.
She's got AIDS for sure now.
Dean got pranked better than anybody else in the whole world.
They call chicks puck bunnies. In lacrosse, they call them lacrostitutes. What do they call them in
pro-hose?
Permastank.
It's a neat game of operation.
Voted to sing about its people and places that make Canada the greatest country in the world.
I got millions of dollars of money, but goddamn, I'm walking funny.
Some big mergers and acquisition meeting down on Bay Street. Just stand up and go, it's a good old hockey game. The best game you can play. Go screw off and play some gay-ass music, loser. So I just told her to go F herself.
The stuff is really runny.
That's when it popped.
So I was on the bottom. Now I'm on top.
Did you hear why Bieber was late for that show?
Well, we have our theories. What's yours?
The car broke down. They said he blew a tranny.
You deserve it. Well played,
sir. The car broke down on the way to the show because Bieber blew a tranny.
Broadcasting on your hi-fi unit's FM band.
In living stereo.
It's the Dean Blundell Show.
102.1.
The Edge.
Sarah Thomson joins us. She is the publisher and CEO of a women's magazine. Is it what's the name of your magazine, Sarah?
It's the Women's Post.
The Women's Post. I'm sorry. And happy International Women's Day.
Happy International Women's Day.
How are you?
I am well. How are you?
We're doing good, except I gotta say, I liked you better with the non-dreaded hair.
Oh, well, you know, what can you do? I like the dreads.
I know you do.
Dreads are funky.
Yeah, they're funky, but like you look like, I'm not sure if you're going to roll me for a quarter ounce or if you're going to get into politics.
Oh, come on.
Well, you've never squeegeed a windshield?
I have, actually.
Have you? Oh, man.
Yeah.
Times are tough over there. But no, listen, Sarah, you ran for mayor a couple of years ago, and and then ran, you're politically motivated. You had some liberal ideas. You may be getting into parliament not long ago, and you've decided just to really focus on your magazine. Any more political aspirations?
Well, actually, I've spent most of my working days are spent at the Transit Alliance, and I'm pushing for a 1% sales tax to go towards the downtown relief subway line. So I've been working on that nonstop for the past year. We got the subway line on the TTC plans, and we got it on the Metrolinx plans. So we've had some accomplishments, and I've been working a lot at City Hall and with some amazing councillors.
Yeah, you have, and you were busy last night apparently at the Canadian Jewish Political Action Party.
Yep, the action party was great.
Big event. How was it?
It was a great party. I went up to Mayor Ford and asked him, you know, why he wasn't at our mayor's roundtable. Last week we had a mayor's roundtable discussion on funding transit and dedicated transit funding, and I asked him why he wasn't there, and he said, "Oh, I was down at my place. I was down in Florida." Without my wife, you should have been there. And I kind of thought, that's weird.
Sorry, so Mayor Ford, you said, hey, you should have been at the mayor's meeting on transit. And he said, so I couldn't have. I was down in Florida without my wife. You should have been there with me. Nudge, nudge, wink, wink.
Yeah, well, Rob doesn't do that. Like, that's not Rob. So I was kind of shocked. I kind of fluffed it off and thought, no, he didn't really just say that. And then we posted a picture and he grabbed my ass. And I thought, okay, he did just say that.
Did he grab, like a full ass grab?
Oh,
fully
yeah.
Grabbed your ass?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Which, the right cheek, the left cheek, more to the middle?
Seriously?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because sometimes it's a graze.
I think it was the right cheek.
Okay,
I think it was the right cheek, yeah.
So, no, because sometimes it's a graze, it could be mistaken for a grab, but this was not an incidental. This was a full ass grab.
Oh, yeah.
How many seconds do you think he was hanging on to the right cheek for, Sarah?
No, I wouldn't. I was just shocked. You know how you go into shock? You're like, I can't believe the mayor of Toronto has just done this.
So. Grabbed your ass.
And he actually physically, like, then moved his fingers and kind of did the squeeze. Like, he didn't just do, like...
Oh,
like,
no, it was a squeeze.
Wow.
Wow. See, now, most people... most people would be flattered. You, however, were not, right?
Well, the fact is, I work with him. Imagine what working with somebody day in and day out. You see him. I was on the campaign show with him for 10 months. And there's a sense of respect you have for someone. And I just looked at him and I was thinking, what the f*** are you doing? Like, why would you do this to me?
I had to take the F word out. I took the F word out just to save your life.
Oh, sorry about that.
So you could say, what the heck?
I was on the radio.
No, you are on the radio. So go back and say, what the heck?
What the heck were you doing? And then I just went to some of his handlers and people around him. I said, you know, you got to get him out of here. This is not Rob I know, and there's something wrong with him.
Is he wasted?
And they went up to him and they didn't, they just let him stay. And I just thought it was pretty bad.
Was he drunk?
He wasn't slurring his words, but he was not the normal Rob Ford that I know.
In terms of, he was even more outspoken than he normally is?
Oh, no, he was, Rob isn't normally a flirtatious guy. He talks business. You know, he's funny and he'll joke around, but he normally wouldn't go that way with me, ever. And so for him to do it, I thought there's something wrong with him.
Well, what do you think was wrong with him? What's your guesstimation? Because you know what,
you
you're
know,
right.
I don't know. I really don't know. I just kind of went, he was not the normal Rob Ford.
Some drugs? Do you think he was high on drugs?
I'm not going to say.
Pills? You think he's having a few pills?
You know, I'm not going to say.
Maybe he was tired. Was he hungry?
Maybe he had too much popcorn chicken.
I have no idea. I just hope we can get some help because, you know, for him to do that with me at that level, there's definitely something wrong. You know?
You know what? Here's the thing is that you're a very professional lady and you've achieved a lot and you're really you should be admired and used as an example for women who want to go out and achieve, that want to go out and do something, want to go out and make a difference. So, you know, there really isn't, even though you've achieved so much, there really isn't a difference between a guy like Rob Ford, and the picture you've posted on your Facebook account is priceless, by the way. He looks very sweaty and he looks like he just might expire before he finishes grabbing your butt.
Well, you know, the sad thing is I've defended him, and I've stood up at meetings and said, look at, you know, you don't go there on him. And I was, I guess I was so mad. I wouldn't punch the guy in the face, you know, and I can't do that. I'm a little bit more mature than that. But, you know, what do? Do I just not say anything, or do I say something? I think it was, I've got to stand up because other women might not, and we got to change this, right?
Yeah. So.
Was it an event where people were drinking and having fun and socializing?
It's the men of Shivets, man.
Yeah. You know what? It was a lot of fun, there were a lot of politicians there. It's an event where you go, and it's a working event. You go, you meet people, you talk to people, you find out the issues.
You have a couple
That's
of mutzes.
That's why you go to these.
Yeah.
Pardon?
You have a couple of mutzes.
I don't think they
Well, you know what? It was a lot of fun.
Well, so now what happens? Like, are you going to follow up? Sarah Thomson, our guest, Rob Ford, they went to a thing last night. She just went over to say hi and wondered where he was. He said, you should have been in Florida with me because my wife wasn't there last week. And then he grabbed your ass, the right cheek.
Maybe he thought you were food.
Did you look like a burrito? No, but literally, what do you do now? Like, do you just, because you posted the picture of him and he's very sweaty, looks very unkempt and very unwell. Do you follow up with his executive? Do you take it to someone? Is there an ethics committee or no?
You know, at the end of the day, I'm not a counselor. I don't actually work there every day. It shouldn't be made into another lawsuit. The Lord knows the poor guy's had enough of those, right? But yeah. I would like an apology. I would like him to change his behavior, and I hope he doesn't do that to someone else.
Yeah.
Yeah. What do you say to some critics already who are saying, did you need to post the picture?
You know, at the end of the day, if you shove it under the carpet and you don't deal with it, it doesn't help the situation to the next woman coming along. Mm. So I disagree with that. I think you have to come out and you have to be open and public.
I agree. And you know, you said it at the end of your statement too. You said Happy International Women's Day, and you know, we need strong women like you, not just in politics, but to be visible with the decisions they make when it comes to standing up for yourself and being harassed. Would you wouldn't have them charged for sexual harassment for grabbing your ass, would you?
No, I mean, I'm tough. I don't need to do that. What I'm doing now, I think, is enough for him to actually try and deal with this issue.
Have you heard from him at all?
I haven't, and I would tip my hat if he calls and apologizes.
What was he like?
I would tell everyone if he did it.
What was he like for the rest of the? Well, good for you, as you should. What was he like for the rest of the night? I mean, was yours the only ass he grabbed?
I have no idea. He was surrounded by people, so I kind of, as soon as that happened, I was in shock and walked away, and told a couple of people, I can't believe he just did this. And you should get this guy out of here. He doesn't belong in a public setting right now. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I know a couple of them were shocked and kind of went up to his handlers and said, you know, this is what he did, like, get him out of here. But they didn't do anything. So
maybe
I left at 11 and he was still there. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, listen.
Wait, what time was the picture taken at?
Gosh, 10? I
wish I saw about 11.
Wow. This, by the look on his face, the picture was taken at 4 in the morning.
Yeah.
No, it was before 11, that's for sure.
Man, he had a good day.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, I gotta go.
Bye, Sarah. Thanks for your time.
Okay,
bye.
Thanks.
Maybe he thought she was a burrito.
She didn't like that.
Hey, look at this, quite the burrito you got down there.
Just put your stuffing down there.
Yeah, you want me to give you a little salsa?
He needs You look at this picture. I tweeted it at It's Dean Blundell. You go look at it. I tweeted it a while ago. Check this guy out. He is an absolute mess. And I, honest to God, feel sorry for him. Hey, listen, we've all been, on my birthday, the 40th birthday, you know when everybody's handing you shots? Someone took a picture of me walking out of the Duchess of Markham, and I was gunned. And it was like, I don't remember parts of the evening, that kind of stuff. And it, whether you're proud of it or not, it happened, but you own it. You go, yeah, dude, some guy emailed me. He's like, I got pictures of you grade 9 drunk. I go, looks more like grade 8 drunk to me.
Yeah, let's be honest.
You own it. But there's no way he can own grabbing some well-respected female's ass at a function and said,
you should have been in Florida with me last night. My wife wasn't there.
You know, the truth of it all is that he chose to become the mayor of the fourth biggest city in North America.
With all the issues he's got.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you have to be careful of your behavior. And we're radio hosts. We don't really.
Yeah. The best news is that St. Patrick's Day is coming up.
Oh, remember him last year?
Oh, yeah. We're going to have a whole bunch of great pictures.
Yeah, the pictures people were sending us.
Round two.
He fell down and couldn't speak.
Yeah. Round two. This is the Dean Blundell Show. 102.1.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Time for Toronto's greatest contest called Wha Happened? Hey, everybody. Hi, The Edge.
I'm just calling for the confession.
Yeah, man. We're doing Wha Happened. Best confession wins. What prize are we giving away there, T-Bone?
We have the Canadian Music All Access Prize Pack.
Yeah.
Canadian Music Week. And also the $100 Montana's gift card.
Ooh. Oh, sweet.
Which, yeah. Yeah, no kidding. It's sweet. $100 at Montana's.
Nice.
Wha Happened?
Hey, Wha Happened?
Hey, Wha Happened?
Get down. Go ahead.
Well, my confession is I cheated on my wife about 2 weeks ago. I went home with this girl. She was a bit freaky. Convinced me to dunk the end of my penis in hot wax. Got a giant blister on the end of my knob, and I've had a condom on for the last week with polysporin in it.
Yeah, sure was hot wax, bud.
Does your wife know about it?
No, I've been just shucking her off for the last week because she keeps trying to get frisky with me, and I can't let her see the condom on, obviously.
Yeah.
But it's like Rudolph's nose. It just swelled right out. Apparently, it's like a move she does. So you dunk it in there, you pull it out, and as it's cooling, my knob was actually swelling, and it flaked all the wax off. So my knob was like not twice the size, but it was pretty friggin' big.
Oh, so... So she really enjoyed it. She thought it would be benefit. See, this is what happens, I bet you, when a chick hooks up with a guy, it's not that big. She's like, oh, go put it in there first so it gets bigger.
Candle dipping.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Imagine putting a wick in the end of that thing.
I love how that's his only concern, not that he just cheated on his wife.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. So anyway, yeah, I cheated on her. But listen to this. At the Edge.
Hi, I got it. What happened?
Wha Happened?
Hey, Wha Happened?
What the f*** happened?
So I was banging my girlfriend. And right as we were getting to the part that some people would refer to as, I guess I left my door open or something because my cat walked in the room, and I swear to God, no word of a lie, it stood up and started licking. So naturally, I dumped my girlfriend because once you got one, that's willing to do that.
Yeah, you're clever. Thanks, dude. Hi, The Edge.
Hey, what's going on, buddy?
What's up, dude? What's your name,
buddy?
Friend.
Wha Happened?
Hey, Wha Happened?
Hey, Wha Happened?
What the f*** happened?
I introduced my wife to my family via nudie pictures by accident.
Ooh, good one. Well, what's the story?
I was down in L.A., met a bunch of my family for the first time, and because I was separated from my father for 20 years. And then when we finally met up, I'm sitting there showing pictures of me and my at the time, future wife. And just so happens to be that in that collage of pictures, there was pictures of her that I was taking of her with, we had a big pile of money that we got from something. And she was covered in it, and I was taking my pictures, having fun, and they wound up on the big screen TV.
She good? I don't know if the pictures were good.
She good?
Oh yeah.
Because imagine if the family's like, whoa.
Gross.
You're not marrying into this family, son.
Hey, The Edge.
Hey, good morning.
Good morning. Who's this?
Steven.
How you doing, Steven?
Good, you?
Good, brother.
Wha Happened?
Hey, Wha Happened? Hey, Wha Happened?
I was unfortunate enough as a child to be sexually assaulted by two separate babysitters at two different ages of my life. One a male, one a female.
What do we do with this one?
Jeez,
he said us.
Yeah, sorry about that. That is terrible. That is awful.
Yeah, it wasn't good. Yeah. Took a bit of therapy when I got a little older, but that's it.
All right, hang on. Oh. What do you do? Do we get rid of that?
Well, bring it down. Mm-hmm. Terrible. So
it's terrible. Hi, The Edge.
Hi, how's it going?
Good. What's your name?
It's Pete.
Hey, Pete.
Hey, I'm calling for Wha Happened.
Wha Happened?
Hey, Wha Happened?
Wha Happened?
I got a real red wagon. Basically, I ruined a possible professional football career in the CFL for severing my toe when I was drying my nuts.
By what?
drying off my nuts getting out of the shower. Was at my dad's place, and I guess he'd clogged the toilet a couple of weeks before I was there.
With a huge poop?
Oh, I didn't see it, but he had dropped the backing of the toilet on the ground and chipped the end of the back part of the toilet off, I guess. So I got out of his shower when I was visiting him and put my foot up on the back of the toilet to dry my undercarriage, and my wet foot slid along the porcelain that was wet. And the chip on the edge of the porcelain, I won't say it almost severed my toe right off, but it cut my toe, nerve damage in the toe. I was at Western at the time playing for their football team as a wide receiver, and I'd been scouted to play for Calgary and BC at the time. And literally mid-football season, virtually severed my toe off, drying my nuts.
And then you never played football again?
No.
That's $42,000 you'll never see.
Yeah.
Did you thank your father?
Yeah.
Sounds like he actually helped you out.
I actually make way more money than that now.
There you go.
The best thing that ever happened to me. Yeah.
Any advice to young football players out there?
Yeah, cut your toes off.
Yeah, if you're going for the CFL,
just cut
your toe off. No.
All right, brother, hang on, okay?
All right.
That's a good one. Hi, The Edge. Your dad did him a favor. Hi, The Edge. Hey. Oh. Hi, The Edge.
Hi, is this Dean?
Yeah.
Hi, Dean.
Hey, man.
Hey, what happened?
I have a more of a what happened and a trial type of story.
Yeah, just whatever.
When I was 8, my dad made me do a brain surgery on my dog.
What a day!
Holy God, Dexter, what happened?
Wow.
It was 8, but I kind of remembered sort of the story when I was 18, and I confronted him. Oh. And from what he told me, he went to the doctor to do the checkup. My dog, or his dog at the time, had a tumor. And the doctor is like, it'll be $20,000 to just do the brain surgery. Oh, no. He looked at the doctor and be like, anyone could do a brain surgery. It shouldn't be that expensive. So the doctor's like, no one could do this brain surgery. And he's like, no, anyone, even my kid could do it. So to prove the doctor wrong,
he sort of
got me to do it. And he was guiding me at the same time, the dog survived.
Really?
Yeah, it went 13, 14 years old. But, yeah.
Did you remove something, like a tumor? What did you remove?
Well, he it was like a carving knife. He was a hunter, so he had the specific tools.
Damn it. Did you put him out, or was he awake, the dog?
He got the dog drunk.
Are you kidding?
To make it easier, at the time he had a part-time job.
He picked up a
dentist office, so he got like sort of those surgical tools to freeze the area.
Oh my God.
Should've got the nitrous while he was at it.
Yeah. Is your dad smoking a cigarette the whole time?
No, he was just like leaning over to... And all this is being done on a kitchen table, too.
Oh, my God.
Are you being serious?
Did it mess you up your whole life? Like, I mean, it would have messed someone up their whole life.
It was like, it's like playing Operation, just high-tech.
Just high-tech.
But
I don't know. Dog didn't buzz.
It's basically,
I don't even know if I can. This has been one of the most disturbing Wha Happens ever. Yeah. God bless y'all.
I love dogs.
What kind of dog was it?
It was a beagle. It was a hunting. It was like his favorite dog. He would do anything for this dog.
Including getting his 8-year-old.
He put his son to do an operation on a dog.
Yeah, you don't enlist your son as a surgeon at the age of 8 to help cut a tumor out of your dog's head.
You get them to remove burrs and stuff. Yeah. That's what little kids should
comb
do
it.
Dogs. Yeah.
Prove the doctor right, though.
Baby stitch. Or,
maybe he's right.
Dog lived.
Little fingers are handy.
Wow. Are you okay now, or are you messed up because of it?
Well, it happened when I was 8, so I kind of forgot about it. But then when I was like 18, I kind of had a little flashback, and I went up to him like, did this happen? And he's like, yeah, I'm surprised you even remember it. And we just started going, I'm like, you're messed up. Who does that? We joke around, but.
Wow.
Is that the only thing?
That I can remember so far. It's probably a flashback come back later on.
Yeah, like, you know, I remember when I was 9, my dad made me do his vasectomy.
Yeah, life of my story.
Wow, you win. Congratulations. Todd will tell you what it is you won.
Yeah, man. You're going to go to the Canadian Music Week, All Access Prize Pack, and a $100 Montana's gift card.
Yeah, that'll erase the memory.
Thanks, guys.
All right, hang on.
And the other guy, too, didn't even win.
Yeah.
What about the wax?
The guy with the penis wax? Unfortunately, that wins every other day but today.
What about the guy with the babysitter?
I know, the babysitter story. Yeah, like
what the hell's going on today?
The Dean Blundell Show.
On 102.1.
The Edge.
This is your Edge.
Stop it. Hold it.
Files with Dean Blundell on the Edge.
The Biebs collapsed on stage yesterday in London, the second of his 2 or 3 sold-out shows I guess he's doing in London. Complaining of shortness of breath.
Breath?
Wiener. I need more. I just can't keep going. I guess I get more. Maybe that was it. He was just low on wiener.
He didn't want to be strapped up in that little harness again. So no one. That's what it was.
Yeah, I'm not doing that harness again. It shows my little wiener. Apparently complaining of shortness of breath during the halfway point of his show, he collapsed and was taken off for 20 minutes, given some oxygen, and decided to come back against doctor's orders. Or so that's what they'd have you believe. Let's do a little bit of PR math, shall we? Has had a terrible month. Gave some interview about his virgin penis the other day. Did you read this?
No, I didn't even hear
you
about this one.
You didn't read the virgin penis? You didn't read about it?
I didn't even hear about this.
You're kidding.
No. I was too busy deeply concerned about his health.
Yeah. And rail, like, he went onto Twitter and just freaked out at people. Like, lost his mind the other day. Because he gave an interview. This is what Justin says. The fans have named my penis Jerry, which is funny, he revealed.
Interesting. You know what? Sorry if I may interrupt.
Yeah.
That's what the British called the Germans in World
Jerry's.
War II.
Interesting.
Because we already said that his fans are like modern day Nazis.
Yeah, they are. They are.
They're so evil. They're so evil.
Dude, I got an email because I think he faked the whole thing yesterday. So my thing was, as I said, he faked the whole thing, and I tweeted it, and some Bieber fan went nutso, like crazy
wants
nuts.
Wants you to die.
Told me they wanted me to die. They hope I died. And that's what Bieber fans do. You remember the Black Keys guy who was like, Justin Bieber's a douche. You should have given him an award for music. Yeah, yeah. I'm glad he didn't get an award because it wasn't music. And then this guy got like death threats for days. Patrick Kearney from the Black Keys. Death threats for days from these 14-year-old idiots. I'd like to collect them all. They're like Nazis. You're right. The last time someone's life was threatened for not agreeing with some, just not agreeing with it.
Yeah.
Or having a difference of opinion. They were the Nazis back in the day. The SS, the Gestapo.
Scary.
The Bieber is very sick.
And then Bieber, who could only be described as modern day Hitler, tweets from his bed. That he was doing okay and recovering and plans to go on with the show.
The show must go on. Hop to it.
He needed a special concoction of
wiener
to get him going again. New kind of energy drink.
Oh, I take out the R. Yeah, energy dink.
Oh,
yeah. Not off the energy. No. Derek's trying to figure it out forever.
Energy dink, Derek. Energy dink.
Yeah.
Yeah, instead of believers, they should just be called Nazis. Little pukes.
Instead of Red Bull, he's a Red Ball.
Little tiny one. Anyway, apparently he collapsed on stage and went to the hospital after he finished his show just so he looks like a hero. Now, my theory was that he faked the whole thing because he's had such a bad time with the PR, talked about shaving and plucking his eyebrows and this, and then the press got on, and then he ran out without a shirt on. And also my theory is this. My theory is that he's got some drug issues now.
Huh.
Because he's going wonky. Like, you know, anytime you see someone start to go a little off, they get massive fame, massive celebrity, then they start going nuts, not showing up for shows and stuff like that. It's drugs. Collapsing. No reason a 19-year-old should be collapsing on stage, running around singing and dancing. That's not exercise.
He's just acting like a tool, yeah. All of it.
Yep.
It'll catch up to him. Eventually, he'll grow up. And his fans will grow up. When he grows up, he won't be as desirable.
He'll know.
And when his fans grow up, they'll give their head a shake. Exactly.
They'll be like, oh, why was I a Nazi?
Then he'll take himself out in a bunker.
Sort of like when the Americans won the war. Hopefully. Sort of like when the Americans won the war and all that. I had a friend whose father was in the German army at the time. And when they found out they were losing, they're like, the commander goes, hey, everybody, we lost. Let's get the hell out of here. So they all split. And then they just denied being Nazis back in the day. So now what you're going to see is a few years, this guy going to get drug-addled and nuts and wear sweatpants and play Proline. And then all these believers will be going,
I swear to God, I never listened to it my whole life. I don't even know who that guy
There's
is.
There's 35 million of you right now, and most of you are under the age of 18. You'll grow up.
Oh, yeah. And then you'll be embarrassed.
Yes, you will.
Dude, I still got a picture. My mom's got a picture of me wearing it with the Michael Jackson perm because I really like Michael Jackson. I was like 12. Think I'm embarrassed? Mortified.
Yeah, it's a tough one.
I hope that picture never sees the light of day.
The Jerry curl.
Yeah.
Do you have the one glove on, too?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay, I used to like Cyndi Lauper. Oh, Just because I wore ripped stockings doesn't mean I was weird, does it? Okay. No.
Yes, it does.
I know.
Yeah, totally. This is your Edgefiles for the hell day. It is in March of 2013.
The Edge Files on 102.1 The Edge.
What's up, everybody? This is Steve-O, and you're listening to Dean Blundell on 102.1 The Edge.
Yeah. Well, hello there.
Oh, yeah.
The Dean Blundell Show presents Ho.
I get to pull out all that cocky.
Renovation.
Dark wood.
That's good.
Who's got the clips?
I sent them yesterday.
You sent them to me?
Yeah. Yesterday around this time.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
That was good of you.
Yeah. Yep. I was going to mention that.
I got him. Thanks.
Woo!
Yeah. Huh?
Yeah.
It's Friday. It's a good day. 9:06, time for whole renovations. Hi, The Edge.
Hey, how are you?
Good, brother. What's your name?
Jeff.
How you doing?
I'm okay.
Where are you calling from?
Toronto, Midtown. Right.
Midtown, Toronto. You going to work today?
I'm working right now. I'm a courier.
Oh, are you? Bike courier or regular courier?
No, I drive.
Phew.
All right. Because the bike counterparts in your job, not nice people.
Scourge.
They make a bad name for us.
Yeah, they do. All right, brother. We're going to play whole renovations. Here's how it works. We're going to give you three clips. First clip, you get all three. Sorry. If you get two out of three, you got to get two out of three basically to win. And the clips are either from a home renovation show or a filthy movie. If they're from a dirty movie, you say ho. Home renovation show, you say home. You ready?
Let's do it.
Here we go.
This wood is so hard. It's tons and tons of pressure. It shows the strength, eh?
It's going to be a home.
That's right.
Clip number two.
How long has it been in there?
Approximately 47 minutes.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's going to be home as well.
Yeah.
Good job. Good job.
Approximately 47 minutes. It's not that long, actually.
No, it's no. pretty good. No.
Clip number three.
Definitely Ho.
Hey,
yeah. You're good.
What's your name?
Jeff.
Jeff, you've won a can of Nona's pasta bite-sized meat ravioli autographed by all of us.
We're not joking.
Sweet.
Right. I hope you're hungry.
Hold on. We'll get your phone number information so we can get this to you right away.
Sweet. You're the guy. Sweet. Thanks. Jerk offs.
The Dean Blundell Show. The Dean Blundell Show. On 102.1 The Edge.
Psychic NIKKI coming up in just a second, so hold on. How's she looking today? Because we haven't had her in for a week, and I remember once we did that, and she almost went out of her head, so to speak. Very stressed out. She's looking all right. Do you see her?
She's always kind of
a little disheveled
in the corner.
Hope she's not mad.
We'll see.
We just took a break last week because we were swamped, or something. You know, I wonder how much weight she's lost this week. You guys want an over under on that or no?
12.
It's usually 12 to 14
pounds.
Hey, what's she
look? Roscoe, you see his face? He just went,
It 12? Depends how big this shirt is today.
I'm going to say 9. You say 12?
Yeah, what it's always say? 12.
She always listens in the back. I should go grab her now.
12, so okay, 12. Say 12. How much weight? 12 pounds? You think she's
like, I think she's going to say 12.
I'm going to say 9. Which, for the year, by the way, would put her at about minus 80 pounds.
She wouldn't look good.
Like, not... She wouldn't be at 105. She'd be at, like, minus 80.
Maybe she is dead.
Roscoe says you got a big ass. Look at your face.
They're both.
Bored. Lonely. Hard up. Use your free hand and follow the boys on Twitter.
Dean Blundell Show.
The Dean Blundell Show.
102.1.
Maybe your life is full of sorrow. Y'all listen up. What? This chick sees tomorrow.
I see tomorrow, I think.
Get mad. It's like that. Get mad.
You lucky.
It's Psychic NIKKI on the Dean Blundell Show.
You'd be lucky to make it to tomorrow.
It's Psychic NIKKI on the Dean Blundell Show.
It's the queen, y'all.
It's Psychic NIKKI.
Do my thing. My thing.
Hey.
Hi.
How's she going?
Yeah, man. Good.
Can I have a drum roll, please? Thank you. Before you got here, we were wondering how much weight you would tell us that you lost this week, because every week you lose between 10 to 15 pounds. Now, you came in here, the first thing you said was, I lost a lot of weight, a lot. And then you turned to your side and you said, look at this. And then you said, I'm getting into clothes I haven't gotten into in like 10 years. So without further ado, because we have a little bet going, I won't tell you how much weight I thought you lost this week.
Okay.
How much weight have you lost this week?
Well, altogether.
No, this week.
Oh, this week? About 5 pounds.
I win.
Yeah?
No, we're all over. Price is right rules.
No,
Price is right rules, bro.
We didn't say Price is right rules. It's not money.
It's the way it works.
It's not money.
5 pounds.
I'm closest.
Okay, but altogether, how much have you lost?
Well, 14 and a half pounds, about 15 pounds since last May.
15 pounds since last May, which is interesting because every week from last May until this,
you've been losing
12 pounds.
Oh, okay. I might have got it mixed up.
Maybe it was 12 ounces?
Maybe.
That's a big deal.
Except these are growing.
Your titties?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know why.
Let's see.
Gravity.
Let's see.
Gravity.
Let's
see.
Next time.
Come on.
What happens with gravity is they get lower and they look bigger.
Right. Yeah.
Come on.
Well, not that low.
Let's have a look at those
Come on,
things.
Rip them open.
Yeah, just pull
Come
a button
on,
open.
Silver I fox.
Just one button.
Let's go.
Let's why see a nipple.
Some clear.
Oh,
oh, my God.
Those are
oh my God.
Big.
You got huge guns.
You're bad. This is International Women's Day. We're not supposed to do this.
Sure, yeah, you are. Celebrate everything.
Yeah,
celebrate nipples. Celebrate breasts. Yep. Right.
Yeah. So
right.
That's the great part of women.
Yeah.
Pretty good guns, eh?
Not bad.
Yeah.
That actually was like
a little bit of did it move?
No. But if I was 90, I'd be
90.
All over
what are you
that?
Talking about?
Nice.
Talking about. I had wolf whistles from 24-year-olds.
No, you didn't.
Week. I did.
Wolf whistles. That's how we know you're 90. That's how we know you're 90.
Is that how they called you for feeding time?
Feeding time, Derek.
You're another wolf whistle, sir.
Yeah, see?
Yeah, see. All right.
And a couple of pig whistles and a wolf whistle.
All right.
Okay, so listen, let's get right to it, okay? Because I want to ask you a couple questions about Rob Ford.
Oh, yeah.
Trouble with Sarah Thomson. But we were the first people, actually, to... she leveled an accusation against the Toronto mayor about him grabbing her ass and then saying, you should have been in Florida with me last week. And there's pictures on my Twitter, at It's Dean Blundell. And I know I didn't post them earlier because I didn't... I effed it up, but they're there now on my Twitter account. But check it out. He looks really wasted.
And I said he has to watch his health.
What kind of...
And
like,
I don't want anything to happen to him.
Because she said it wasn't him. It was like he was on something. But didn't want to say what, didn't know, had no idea, whatever.
He going to go to rehab?
He could go into the hospital. That's what I'm worried about, his health. I keep on warning him, you know, telling him.
No, he looked pretty good.
Pretty good.
Oh!
Yeah, he's got to watch his health, Dean. And, you know, people do things at parties, though, right?
This was the Canadian Jewish party. Political action party event.
Well, maybe he had a few drinks.
No, but you know what is
interesting? Yeah, could have had a few drinks.
Yeah. What is interesting, though, it is on the Sarah Thomson's Facebook page.
Yeah.
If you scroll back like four or five pictures, there's them at an event together, Sarah Thomson and Rob Ford from 2011. And she's like all over him in the picture. It's very hypocritical, actually. Anyway, I'm just saying. What?
Since when did you turn into a sleuth?
No, I'm
since
just
when
saying.
Did you turn into Rob Ford's friend?
No, I'm not his friend. I'm just saying it is a party.
Now, I said there would be a sex scandal at City Hall, so that's kind of a sex scandal.
Not really.
It? Not really?
He just grabbed her ass, allegedly.
Yeah, but there could be more women coming out of the closet.
Saying that he grabbed their ass?
Oh, I see.
We got ourselves a big fat ass grabber.
But, you know, there could be divorce, too.
With him and his wife?
Look, it's a couple years before. They look like they're friends. They're buddies.
You're an idiot if you think that's not incriminating. She just got her arms around like, hey, look, I'm with the big fat man.
Yeah, so he just got her on
it's
her
a
butt.
Cute one. You're an idiot.
He probably is on some drug for his health, maybe.
Yeah, made him goofy last night.
And maybe he had a couple of drinks. And you know.
I can guarantee you he had a couple of drinks.
Yeah and, you know, Sarah Thomson, she's very conservative, but very sexy in her own way.
She's not sexy.
She's not conservative either.
No.
You don't think so?
No,
neither. Okay. Well, anyway, you know how it is.
She's got dreadlocks.
I don't know how
anyway,
it is.
Anyway, he has to watch his health. Now, another person I said had to watch his health was Justin Bieber.
Yeah, and he collapsed on stage because he huffed a lot of vina.
He did. So he's got to
What's his
careful.
Deal? Is it drugs with him? Because he's going off his, like, he's off his rocker.
You know what?
Do you see a drug problem with him?
I see people around him influencing him
in
the way of drugs are not good for him.
Yeah.
Honestly, he's got to change his friends or people around him.
Scooter. He's got to get her a scooter.
I hope he doesn't change his friends. I hope he gets even more drugged out friends.
He may get new management and new agents. Too.
Really?
Yeah. Mm. Something like that. But he's still got to be careful. Yeah.
Agents. Todd.
Agents.
Oh.
Not Asians.
I was like, what?
She didn't say he needs new Asians around him.
We'll make you top of
right.
the world.
Agents.
Now, I also predicted...
to take him to number one.
Number one. With a bullet.
You know what I think he really needs is some new Asians.
Well, you know what? He's very young.
And
right?
dumb.
And I keep on telling everybody that he has to... He's got to be careful of danger, careful of health...
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Okay, so we've dealt with Bieber. Let's deal with Drake, one of my other favorites.
Oh, Drake,
Oh, I was just thinking, because she said Bieber had to be careful of danger and stuff. Where those guys almost
tried to cut his nuts off.
Are you sure they weren't successful, though?
Actually, I predicted it before they did it.
that one picture looks like they actually did it.
Yeah.
But I predicted it before. Oh, the shot of the small one. Yeah, I know.
So let's. Can I ask you about Drake? Do you see Drake's career going into the crapper soon?
Probably.
Yes.
Yeah. You know what?
Knew it.
I have nothing against anybody, okay?
I do.
Because I like rap music. I don't mind it.
You may be better than that, but I'm not.
But
we love rap music. This is a fraud, though. It's not rap.
Like, you know, he may go into some more acting, but I see danger around him, too.
Yes.
I see danger. You know, he's going to get into a fight, another fight.
Yeah, and not be able to finish it.
Because I see him before a judge. Like, I see this big fight happening with him. And I
guarantee you see him before a judge, and he loses that fight, too.
Right. Now, he may father a child, too.
Really? That'll be a first, huh?
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey. That'll be a first.
It'll be called Little Drake.
Hey, there'll be
science. Science will be scratching their head about that one.
How'd that guy get birth?
Yeah. Birthed out of his giant navel.
Well, not him, but some girl.
His boyfriend.
Right? Yeah. A boyfriend?
Whatever.
Oh, really? Is that what you think, Dean?
I don't know.
Oh, I don't know.
I don't know. I don't know many real men that make duck faces for every picture they take, though.
Taking the Drake cake.
But you know, like, Drake, like, you know, sometimes they're not everlasting, these people. Like, Michael Jackson was everlasting.
What do you mean?
I know you don't, you know.
What does that mean? What does it mean, everlasting?
Well, he's, you know.
Oh, he's good. Yeah, totally. Unfortunately, what Michael Jackson did on this planet will last forever.
Right.
But guys like Creed, the band Creed.
Yeah. Exactly.
That's not, and same thing, hopefully, with Drake. That's not going to continue.
Not like Michael Jackson and Whitney Houston.
Yeah.
Not like that. Now, I did predict a sinkhole would swallow a man.
You did.
Yeah, I mean, I found it on
Twitter.
Then
we made a bunch of stinkhole jokes. Remember
exactly.
that? I totally remember that.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah,
and it's a very unfortunate thing because the guy was in his bed watching TV.
It was
and
his
all
time.
Swallowed 100 feet down. So then it can't even revive his body.
Yeah, his one tooth brother was so upset.
You know, we could get that here too. You never know. We don't want that, right? Now, I do see some big splits in Hollywood coming up.
What do you see?
I see Jennifer Garner and Ben Affleck splitting.
No.
Really?
Yes, really. Tori Spelling
After his Oscar speech, you think that didn't go well?
Oh, yeah. Right. We fight a lot and we're in trouble.
It's work.
It's work.
Yeah. Right.
Look at her.
Tori Spelling
J-Lo.
Splitting.
She's bigger than me. Yeah. Tori Spelling and Dean McQueen splitting? Or
yeah, they're going to split.
Well, who cares about them?
And they could split. You know, people could split. At the time of this big full moon, the super moon. There's a big super moon coming on March 19th, which is very soon.
All right.
And it's coming very close to Earth. And when that happens, the tides change. Everything happens.
Is it going to look pretty, though, aesthetically?
It'll look like it's falling to Earth. It's so
gonna
huge.
Look pretty?
Yeah. It's going to look
it'll
pretty,
light up
Todd.
The night sky, will it?
It will, Todd. It will. It's almost like a pregnant woman, like a big...
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's
and
so
it's going to be very, very big. So in other words, you could, giant monster moon. And it will actually get very close to Earth. Now, it hasn't been since 1992 that this has happened, that it's got that close to Earth. It's 14% larger and 30% brighter. So Todd was right. It's very, very bright. And you'll see it coming close. And it raises high tides. Dogs will howl. Remember when you see those movies?
Dogs will howl.
You know those movies like the Wolfman and
dogs
everything?
Will howl.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, actually, that was at the time of the full moon.
Wasn't it?
It's a full moon, too. And it's a bad moon. It's a very bad moon for all the astrological signs because people could fight. There could be problems. Not
will werewolves good. Come out?
Werewolves could come out. I believe in that.
Or are they just a bunch of hairy chicks?
No, in Transylvania, in Romania, they have werewolves.
Sure they do.
Yeah, they do. And probably here.
Yeah.
And you know, that's probably, you know when I said Bigfoot?
Here.
That's probably what it is.
Okay.
You know? Now, they're going to find actually leopard octopuses or octopi. You know, a leopard one.
Did we get
really?
It?
Really?
Yeah.
Like one with leopard kind of like
a
skin.
Like a leopard. Like an actual leopard.
Yeah,
like an
actual.
Now, another thing I said was that a woman would get killed
leopard
by a lion.
Puss.
Okay, a zookeeper got killed by a lion in California.
Leopard puss is a cougar.
Watch out for the leopard puss. Yeah.
This weekend at my apartment.
What's that?
Watch out for the often found leopard puss down there at Crocodile Rock.
Oh, really? Would you mind leopard?
Heads up for them leopard pusses at Two Cats.
They will attack. Yeah, do not go there. I mean, go there. But just be careful.
It's like leopard calamari.
Okay.
Okay, anyway. Now, I did say somebody would be attacked by a lion and get killed.
Yeah, you did.
And so that poor woman got killed.
Did you hear what it did?
It opened the gate with its own paw.
It unlocked the gate. It got a key.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then...
Unlocked the gate.
Yeah, it was unbelievable. Yeah.
Went and looked for the easiest one to kill.
Now, I also predicted...
Ate her. Like, ate
no, he broke
no,
neck.
No, he broke her neck.
Oh,
instantly.
Yeah, he just put her in a... In like a full Nelson.
Nelson.
Yeah.
Like Steven Seagal in Hard to Kill.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I just said animals are going to get really bad to people. they're going to be really, they're going
to
attack people.
You don't have to be a genius to know that you shouldn't be walking around with lions.
Not only lions, dogs, cats, at the time of the full moon. And also, Hugo Chavez, I said he would die.
You did?
Yeah. I'm sorry to hear it, but
I'm not.
You're not? Why is
that? Well, you know, it's funny. Everybody hates Hugo Chavez. Every Western leader hates him. I thought he was pretty funny. And he actually did a lot for that
country.
He
did some good things. Yeah,
he cut that country's poverty by a half.
Right. Now, Dennis Rodman.
Should know not to get
she
into
added a ton into that. Yeah.
I should know in conversations with NIKKI.
Dennis Rodman. Now, he's friends with the president of Korea.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
what's going on? You said earlier off the air, you said North Korea is going to launch a nuclear attack on South Korea.
Absolutely.
Then the U.S. is going to just level North Korea.
Absolutely. And they want to send a nuclear bomb. And I said there would be one sent to New York. Now, it could be a very quasi-nuclear bomb. I don't see the end of the world, for sure. Huh. But it's pretty scary.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because this guy in North Korea, he could do something like that, you know?
Yeah, I don't think it's going far.
No.
If he's constipated, a bad day or something, he might just decide to push the button.
That's
I don't know.
It.
But you can bet your boots Dennis Rodman will be okay.
Do it.
Anyway.
Yeah, he survived Madonna.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He can live through any nuclear attack.
Right. Now, there's going to be a plane in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and it's going to hit a television tower.
Okay.
Yeah, I see that. And a barn with racehorses will go up in flames in Kentucky. In Kentucky, I'm so sorry to say that.
Then they'll put them in some meatballs.
Yeah.
Mislabeled.
And a famous movie star is going to be arrested for drug smuggling.
A movie star?
Yeah. And a lot of drugs. Not just taking them themselves. It's probably to just sell on the streets and stuff. Even though they have the money.
Just for the danger aspect?
Just for the danger aspect. Or, you know, because a lot of them like living life on the edge. A male stewardess, he is going to jump out of a plane because he's sick of the turbulence. So he's just going to open the plane and jump out. And he's sick of his job. The only thing is he's going to die.
Yeah, well, of course, yeah.
Yes, yes.
See you later.
I have had enough. The turbulence is too bumpy. And whoever that dick is in seat 7A, there's no more peanuts. I'm out of here.
Wish my butt was named 7A.
I think he should have put up with the turbulence because he's going to die way down there, 38,000 feet above or something.
I said peanuts. Peanuts.
Oh.
I love peanuts. Anyway, I said there would be a volcano at Mount Etna in Italy, and it erupted already.
Okay. Oh, yeah, good one.
And Paris, France will get an earthquake, as well as Montreal and Toronto. And I also
see... Why wouldn't you lead locally?
Yeah.
I also see a chocolate...
Oh, yeah, we're getting it, too.
Yeah, right. Chocolate truck will be hijacked with millions of dollars worth of chocolates. Two subways will collide in Tokyo. Okay? And I see a man stealing fish from an aquarium. But the only thing is, they're man-eating. It's a man-eating fish, so it eats the person, you know? They're going to... Because, you know, tropical fish are very, very rare. And they're trying to sell them on the black market or whatever. Giant earthquake in Indonesia soon, again. I see a train derailing off a mountain in the Rockies coming, and it's going to fall like thousands of feet below. That's not good. And you know that lady that used to be on All in the Family?
The fat one?
I don't know what her name was, but she's Edith.
Was she fat?
Yes, right. I don't think she's going to be around that long. See that. Also, I do see a bank in flames in Toronto. I see a bank going up in fire and flames in Toronto.
Bank
with all the money burning.
Really?
Oh, no.
Yeah. Yeah. And a famous actor from Boston will get shot, whoever that is.
Hey, maybe it's your buddy, Derek.
Who's that, Derek?
Who's shooting me?
Who's that?
So dumb.
Mark Wahlberg.
Oh, Mark Wahlberg.
Ouch.
Oh, dear.
What happened, Mark?
The guy shot me, like right in the arm.
God, I
hope.
Damn.
What do you want me to say to your mom?
Say hi to her. I'm bleeding.
Hi, this is Rick Mercer from the Mercer Report on CBC. If you're currently being weaned off your meds, listen to the Dean Blundell Show on 102.1 The Edge.
Psychic Nick is here.
Oh, hi, guys. Miss you guys.
Miss you, too.
Let's go to the phones. Can we take some calls?
Oh, absolutely.
Hi, The Edge.
Oh, hi.
Hey, Kev.
Hey.
Hi, it's Kevin, yeah.
Yeah, I know. What's up? What are you up to?
I talked to NIKKI.
Yeah, you're on. What are you up to? What are you doing? Nothing?
I'm just chilling, yeah.
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 What's your question?
Oh, I see if I have a lot of luck.
If you have luck?
I got lots of no.
What is your sign?
I got bad luck.
You got bad luck?
What do you mean you got bad luck?
Always.
What do you mean? How?
Well, I always get crappy nurses.
You get crap in your food?
No,
crappy
I always nurses. Get.
Crappy nurses.
Yeah, all the time.
Oh, okay.
And what else?
Do you see this guy, first of all, do you see this guy walking anytime soon?
You know, it could be in the future,
no.
but you know, not right now.
Yeah,
no, you know, I don't want to give him false hope.
Yeah, that's
right. But I think he's doing pretty good right now.
Yeah,
I
what
really
else do you see for him?
Win a lottery.
I see you actually Kevin. getting tickets
new
to a
bib?
Concert.
Oh yeah,
yeah, I do.
Yeah, a Craig Gass concert.
A Craig Gass concert.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's
congratulations.
Probably
good. Good for you.
Yeah.
Have a great day.
Yeah.
Hi, The Edge.
Hi.
Hey, what's your name?
Ashley.
What's up, boss?
How are you?
Good. How you doing?
Good. I got a question for NIKKI.
Sure.
Alrighty. So I've been like a mistress for about 4 months.
You with dirty.
With my boyfriend. Well, they sold their house and everything else. So he's gone to the States with her. He's got two kids. I just want to know if he's still having sex with her and if they're going to be getting back together.
Oh, he's having sex with her, all right, and you. The two of you.
Sounds
know?
Like you might be having sex with her, too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying, sex. Sister?
You know, he wants his cake and eat it, too. I'm sorry to tell you that.
They don't call it cake.
No.
He's kind of used.
They do when you get that old.
Yeah.
Really?
I guess so. It's a little mushier than normal.
Mushier than cake? Pudding?
Upside more down cake.
More like a hairy moose.
You're right, Derek. Maybe pudding.
What's the deal? How do you know he's doing his ex-girlfriend?
I don't know that he's doing his ex-girlfriend. I was just calling in to see.
Why are you suspicious, though? Like, what are your suspicions based on?
Like, they seem to have grown closer because they sold their house and they each bought separate houses. Like, I understand they have kids and everything, but they just seem to be a little bit closer than what they were before.
Yeah.
Ashley, he's not going to get a divorce.
You know what you need to do?
Yeah, he's
you know,
using
you know what you,
you
should do? Or you should just say to him, hey, listen, I understand what's happening.
Mm-hmm.
Here, if you want to be with her, just please let's do that. Go
well,
do that
instead of married to her.
Well, no, but if you want to be with her still, like if you guys, please go and do that. I don't want to waste my time.
Yeah.
Yeah, but he's living with her common law, right?
No, he's not. They sold their house. They each bought separate houses. They're not living together. Or anything.
Yeah, but they were living together.
Yeah, they were.
Yeah, so that's like a marriage.
Where does he live now?
He has his own house out east.
Where?
By Oshawa area.
Oh, I thought you made it seem like he's out of town. Like,
in the States.
Yeah.
Oh, no, he just went to the States because his son has a hockey tournament, so.
But Ashley, yeah. I'm going to tell you this. You're going to have an older sugar daddy.
An older sugar daddy?
You are.
How old is this guy?
He's 35.
How old are you?
26.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, you're going to have somebody older and richer.
Yeah, within, 10 years is my limit. I won't go any higher than that.
You know what? If the guy's got $1 million or more, you will.
Yeah, money's just paper, though. That doesn't really matter to me.
Atta girl, dirty paper.
Anyway, I see another man around you, and I see a younger man and an older man.
Okay,
so you
flipped that one pretty good when you found out she had a 10-year limit, didn't you?
No.
Okay.
I still see her with an older guy, but I'm getting a visual, Todd.
Sorry. Okay.
No, Ashley, what I'm saying is that you're going to have
one.
There's also a young guy as well.
Yeah.
He's gonna be
doing it all.
Yeah, besides
who's
this guy,
the kid,
but
a baby there?
He's using you. You're using him in a way too.
Have a great day. Good luck. Hi, The Edge.
Hello.
Hey.
Hi. How are you?
Good.
That's good. I have a question for Psychic NIKKI.
Sure.
Some guidance on the baby daddy drama in my life.
Yeah. It sounds like you got babies, but how many daddies to those babies?
Just two. I was married once though.
Okay, so you got two babies and
three babies. Two baby daddies.
Okay, how old are the kids?
9, 7, and 2.5.
Okay, so two are with the two oldest with the same guy, one with a different guy?
That's correct.
Okay, and what happened in the relationship with the older guy and what happened with the younger guy?
Okay, the older guy had a threesome, went bad, went for the other chick.
Oh, big risk. It's a big risk you take.
That's your fault, by the way.
Yeah,
it totally is. Totally, totally is.
Okay,
I
then
thought
you,
I could trust them.
No. Then you we arranged a threesome. I thought I could trust them, and that didn't work out.
Did the chick and the threesome have children?
No, she didn't.
Exactly.
Yeah, now okay. She has my children.
Oh, no.
What,
like,
she, he, like your kids live with him?
Yeah.
Why?
Why? Because my daughter's disabled, and I knew that she needed more routine. So going back and forth, it wasn't fair to them.
Yeah.
So I was trying to be the bigger person.
Good shouldn't have had that threesome, hey?
I know.
Pandora's box, huh?
You got it. Exactly. Yeah.
So,
and then the second guy.
Oh, it actually might have been something else. Anyway, go ahead. Second guy, what happened?
Second guy, he got me charged for assault. I went to jail for 3 days.
Well, what did you do?
You sound like you're a pretty tough chick.
Mm-hmm. Thanks.
Did you beat him up?
No. Actually, he was in my face, and I headbutted him.
Oh, God.
Really? I'm wondering why these aren't working out.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I think it's partially my fault.
And why did you want to know?
No, you don't need Nikki's guidance.
You need a lawyer.
You need an anger management class.
Thanks, Dean.
Go ahead, Nick.
Yeah, what did you want to ask?
I just want to know how this is going to play out with me being the bigger person with the older children. And this,
When you mean bigger, do you mean physically bigger?
No, not bigger that way. Like, me thinking of the children's needs first. How is that going to play out? And then with my younger guy, is this guy ever going to grow up and actually be a good dad?
Oh, you're still together after you headbutted him and went to jail?
No, I'm not together with him. No.
You headbutted him.
Solo. Yes, I did.
You're solo now.
Yes.
So why?
That way for some time.
So why? Let me ask you. Why are you asking if he's going to get it together if you just got out of jail?
Oh, I wasn't just in jail. No, I want to.
It doesn't matter.
He has been in jail a lot of times, and I finally stood up for myself. I didn't do it the right way, but just want to make sure that things are going to work out.
How old are you?
I'm 35.
Okay.
No, you're not.
Okay, now I see a man named Mark in the future around you.
Oh.
Yeah. What do you mean, oh?
No, I don't know any Marks.
Not yet.
Not yet, that's right.
You're going to be with a Mark, and you may go to jail again, but just for a short, like an overnight or something.
Oh, that's
for something
scary.
Else?
She may meet this Mark in jail. I don't know.
Jesus. I don't want to meet no guy in jail.
No, just a minute.
Don't want to meet no guy in jail.
This Mark has a uniform, so he could be a cop.
Oh, okay.
Okay, he looks good.
She likes that.
You like that, too?
There's a fantasy there.
It could be interesting.
Yeah, and it's funny because I'm getting the name Owens.
No, actually, my son's name is Cohen.
Cohen, okay, that's what it is. Then.
Yeah.
Your son's name is Cohen?
Does he even know his, when you look at him through the crib bars, do you go, man, I miss jail?
No.
But you know, don't
you look like daddy right now.
The Dean Blundell Show, 102.1 The Edge.